Hello, my name is Jeff Carmio. I'm a freshman here on campus studying finance and data science with a minor in marketing. And the article I've chosen for you today is Data Science on the Front Lines of Battling Climate Change. It was written on May 18th, 2022, so a relatively recent article. It was written by Luis Alvarez for Wired. So just a brief summary of the article. CO2 and CO2 emission levels are at an all-time high, with Arctic sea ice levels decreasing by around 13% per decade, as shown by this chart by NASA. It was also quoted in the article. And the hottest years on Earth have been ever since the year 2000, but gradually each year, the average temperature is slowly increasing. And so global warming is a huge thing. It's an issue that we can't deny is already happening, but it's not really 100% up to the people to fix this issue. Nearly 100 companies are responsible for 70% of all greenhouse gas emissions. And companies like China's coal company and Saudi Arabia oil company make up nearly 20% of that 70%. And this has been going on since 1988. And so this is where data science and AI can come in and step forward. Startup companies like CO2 AI are writing computer programs to analyze greenhouse gas emissions in corporation supply chains. And so they, for example, when making a product, you go back and forth between different companies. Certain companies make certain things. Companies like CO2 AI will track this movement of product and see where greenhouse gas emissions are super high in this process, and hopefully target those companies and aid them in negating the amount of greenhouse gases that is available. And so just a little tidbit is only 9% of companies actually track their greenhouse gas emissions. Only 5% make changes based on the data. Only 1% of these companies actually follow and achieve the goals that they set for themselves when changing this data. So data science and AI isn't the solution. It's a part of it. But this article is mainly saying we need to have a call to action of these companies to hopefully do something and track their data and start hopefully fixing and implementing some of these solutions that could be made. And so my reaction, my choosing for this article is I want to be a data scientist or an analyst of some sort. My personal goals is I want to work for a company and be a data scientist or an analyst of the business plan and model. I'm going to track their spendings and fundings and like just all this raw, unregulated data that all these companies have that could be implemented into their business plan. I want to do that. I want to write the computer programs to do that. So it's just nice to know that companies like CO2 AI are starting up where I could go work for them and do a little bit of the same thing, but also have a big sustainability boost and impact, a greater impact on society, while also still being able to be a data scientist and analyst and deal with numbers and statistics, because that's my thing. And so how this ties back to what we're learning in class, it's really a big question of ethics, corporate social responsibility, and corporate sustainability plans. So ethics, according to the textbook, is a person or organization's beliefs regarding what is right or wrong. And so this whole scenario is a big ethical dilemma, and it's honestly kind of a scary one, because these 100 companies can make or break what happens to the earth. They make the large ethical decision of, is climate change enough for me to potentially lose out on some fundings or whatever? And like, they have all this like power in their hands, and it's just this decision to be made. They have a corporate social responsibility, which also according to the textbook is how these businesses live and grow as a human society and how they value human dignity. And so these companies need to be having these corporate sustainability plans and create these green strategies, protect the environment, and use the tools that these startup companies like CO2 AI have and help reduce the amount of emissions they have, because ultimately these companies don't exist if the earth doesn't exist. So it's just something that they need to be reaching out to and like sort of thriving off of. And so it's kind of already been hinted before, but the main moral of the story and like the ever-going theme from this article is that these tools exist for these companies to reduce their carbon footprint. They just need to be implemented. The quote that I found that like really summed this all up was from Charlotte Degot, who is a managing director at Boston Consulting Group. Boston Consulting Group recently implemented the strategies that CO2 AI has. And Charlotte Degot says a quote as a response to that. And she says that this whole scenario is all about leveraging AI as a part of many other things to move towards action. And honestly, we've been missing a good amount of action, and something needs to happen. We know the solutions are out there. We have the tools to do it. Let's jump on the right one and implement it right now. And so with that being said, data science and AI has already revolutionized numerous different industries. Now it's about time we about use it to stand up for some good and fight for sustainability on this earth. And it's just something that we need to take charge of as a sort of public community to step on these, like to force these, not force, but work together with these companies to help analyze their emissions and work with data science and AI to help analyze their emissions and get us going in the right direction with these companies. So thank you very much for listening to my talk on data science on the front lines of battling climate change, and I hope you enjoyed it.